This is part 6 of multiplying polynomials. We'll be squaring a binomial. But first, let's simplify each of these expressions using the order of operations. You might want to put this on pause and try it yourself first. Okay, so using order of operations on the left here, we have to do inside parentheses. So 3 plus 4 is 7. So we have 7 squared. That means 7 times 7, or 49. On the right-hand side, no parentheses, so then we do any exponents. So we have to do the 3 squared and we have to do the 4 squared. 3 squared is 3 times 3, 4 squared is 4 times 4, and so we get 25. So the first thing I want you to notice is that these two expressions, 3 plus 4 squared, that's not the same as 3 squared plus 4 squared. So caution, in general, if you have something in parentheses like an a plus b squared, it is not a squared plus b squared. Unless they're both, or if one of those letters are zero, it'll be true, but that's the only time. Okay, so what is a plus b squared? Well, to square something means you multiply it by itself. So it's really just a plus b times a plus b. So let's go ahead and do that using FOIL. So we have the first term times the first term is a squared. The outer terms multiplied together is ab. And I'm going to write that as 1ab, so you see the coefficient. That's up to you. You could leave it as ab. Then we have the middle terms, the inner terms, b times a. I'm going to write that alphabetically, so it's easy to see that that's the same like term is the previous one. And last, b times b is b squared. So the two middle terms here, which came from the outer and the inner products, add up to 2ab. So this is the formula in general if you've got a plus b squared. So let's do another problem, writing out the meaning of squaring, which is fine. You don't have to use the formula. If we do this problem, we're going to, again, we could do FOIL. 3x times 3x is 9x squared. 3x times 5 is 15x. Inner term, 5 times 3x is also 15x. And the last terms in each parentheses multiplied together is 25. I get 9x squared plus 30x plus 25. So I'm not using a formula, I'm just writing out the meaning of what happens when you square something. Now let's take the formula and try this. A plus b squared. We just came up with this formula. And let's put in 3x and 5 for a and b. So I've got to do 3x squared plus 2 times my a term is the 3x, and my b term is the 5, plus the b term squared, which is the 5 squared. And if we did it that way, 3x squared is 3x times 3x. 2 times 3x times 5 is going to be 30x plus 25. So notice I get the same answer using the formula for squaring a binomial. So this is a special formula for a special product. You're squaring a binomial. And notice that way up here when I did 15x and 15x, where did the 15x come from? It came from 3x times 5, right? If you look what's in parentheses, the 3x times the 5, and then I've got two of them. So that's why you end up with 2 times the 3x times 5. 2 15x's added together adds up to 30x. You might also be able to do the formula without showing this little middle step here by doing some of that multiplication in your head, and that's okay. You could say, well, I know the first term's going to be 3x times 3x, right? So that's 9x squared. And then how would I get the middle term? I got to do 3x times 5, right? You're going to take each those together and multiply together, that's 15x, and then you got to double it. So 15x times 2 is 30x, and then I'm going to do 5 times 5. So Someone might be able to go directly to the answer, but nobody is going to, right? We know it's not 9x squared plus 25, right? No, 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 no. Not equal, there's going to be that middle term of 30x. Here's one for you to try. Put the video on pause and try it, and then come back. Okay, so you could have done this by writing it out as 2x plus 7 times 2x plus 7, or you can go directly to the formula and write it as 2x squared plus 2x times 7 plus 7 squared, or, you know, you could have maybe done it in your head, but everybody in the end should have gotten 4x squared plus 28x plus 49. So how you start the problem is up to you, but when all is said and done, we should have all got 4x squared plus 28x plus 49. What about if we had a minus b squared? Well, this would mean a minus b times a minus b. So let's do this. Using the FOIL method, we have a times a, it's a squared. Now we're going to do the outer, multiply those. That's going to be minus ab, and just to make it simple, I'm going to write minus 1ab. And the inner is also minus 1ab. It's optional whether you put the 1 there, correct? And then the last will be a negative b times negative b, which is plus b squared. So what's that give us? These two middle terms add up to negative 2ab plus b squared. So this is the formula for squaring a binomial when there's a minus in the middle. It looks almost the same as a plus in the middle, right? That was a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So those are your two formulas. What's the difference? Well, they both have an a squared plus a b squared. Notice that the first and the last term, they're both a squared and plus b squared. But there's that middle term, as we call it, because it ends up being a trinomial. And if there's a minus sign in the parentheses, the minus sign goes in front of the 2ab. And if there's a plus sign, there'll be a plus sign in front of 2ab. So here we are. We have a special product of squaring a binomial. A plus b squared equals a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. And then we have the new one, a minus b squared. The only difference is we'll have a minus sign for the middle term, a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. And remind you of the other special product we did in the previous video, a plus b times a minus b equals a squared minus b squared. Remember that we ended up getting a difference of two squares. So we've got three formulas, so I want you to put the video on pause and try these. You could use the formulas, or you could multiply out by using FOIL. Okay, so let's see how you did. X plus 8 times x minus 8 is x squared minus 64. That's the one that's the difference of two squares. X plus 8 squared is not x squared plus 64. But we do start out with the x squared, and then we do 2 times x times 8. So that's going to be 16x, or you could have written this out x plus 8 times x plus 8, done FOIL, smiley face, whatever. And then we're going to have the last term squared, which is 8 squared. And for the last one, it's almost the same as the previous, except that I've got a minus sign. So the difference will be a minus in front of the 2ab, so it'll be a minus 16x. So we have x squared minus 16x plus 64. Actually, there's a cheer, sort of a chant, to help you remember the formulas for scoring a binomial. So let's just look at these one more time. A plus b squared, it's the first term squared, plus 2 times the product of the first and the last term, plus the last term squared. And the second one's the same thing, except we've got a minus sign, right? So really, it's the first term squared. It's the same sign as whatever's in parentheses, 2 times the product of the two terms plus the last thing squared. So here's how it goes. Okay, ready? First squared, same sign. 2 times the product plus the last squared. With me now. First squared, same sign. 2 times the product plus the last squared. Here's a quick example. We're doing 3x minus 2 squared. First squared, 9x squared. Same sign, minus. 2 times the product. All right, so we got to multiply. 3x times 2 is 6x. Twice that is 12x. Plus the last squared, plus 2 squared. And there you are.